Hello everyone and welcome back. Tonight we're going to be doing a fast preview of the Jagdpanzer E100. I just unlocked this. No games in it yet. And thanks to the x5 and x3 that's been going on and some free XP, you are now seeing what I think is at least probably the coolest tank in the game. I don't know. I like the sound, especially since the update with the sounds. When this thing fires, it's a pretty big boom. So, anyway, let's take a look at the armor real quick. We'll take a look at the gun and get it into a battle. So, here we are. Looks like the upper plate is about 330, except for right in here, but that's still going to be a bounce, 320 or so, 315. The lower plate, just like the E100, it's exactly the same. It's your weak point. The superstructure is about 280, roughly. The lower down you get, it's slightly angled, as you can see. It's more angled than what the Jag Tiger is. And so when you get down below or toward the bottom, you're looking at 270. The higher up you go, close to 290. the cupola is about 180. Dead center as you go out to the sides, obviously. So, you know, if you're shooting at this, there's your weak spot. And, you know, down here, as long as you got the penetration. If you're in a tier 9 TD or tier 9 heavy tank or tier 10s, you know, you can go through this section. The sides are spaced armor, just like on the E100. You can see, you know, you're looking at 400 to 500, roughly. And you can side scrape as well. The side of the superstructure is 450, 445, 440, somewhere around there. So, if you're side on with it, obviously you can pin the side. I wouldn't shoot down here, especially if you're shooting heat. But you know, this big old giant rectangular trapezoid here, I guess is what it would actually be, is the spot to hit, and if you can get behind it as well, which is typical. The other thing, if you're shooting down on it, you'll notice that the armor here is only about 40. So if you're up on a hill and you're shooting down, this is the spot you want to hit. Or, obviously, oh, that's, I don't know what's going on there. Effective armor is pretty high there, but pretty low down here. So, anyway, back to the gun. So, we're looking at a massive, massive gun on this thing, pretty much. 299 is your pin with AP, 420 is with heat, 1050 is your alpha. So, not quite as, I don't know, this and the 183 are the big dogs as far as the guns, besides your RT. Artillery is, you know, my a Jagdpanzer, or the, what is it, the GW Tiger P, sorry, is 2,000, but, you know, that's artillery for you. So, let's see, rate of fire is 2.33, dispersion is your typical German, you know, accuracy, 0.35, aim time is 2.7, so, you know, you're going to have plenty of time to aim this thing. You're only, you know, you're firing about once every 25 seconds, and that's not with a top crew would probably get it down to maybe 20, well, closer to 25. I probably will. I don't have, well, I've got the cash, but I don't, or the credits, but I don't want to spend it. I'm gonna end up buying another tank, so I'm gonna get a rammer for this though. Yeah, all the tanks that I keep, actually, I might have one. Nope, never mind. All the tanks I keep, I equip. But as I'm going through the line. I don't. So anyway, you only got you don't have that many shells, as you can see. One thing, I don't know what the HE 85 and 1400, so I think that's the same as what's on your the E100, if I remember right, or pretty close. 85 and 950, yeah, 85 pin though. So you can see the similarities in the hull of these two tanks. I mean, there's not a whole lot of difference. Actually, there is no difference really, except for the superstructure there. So the hull itself is identical to an E100. If you've got an E100, you're gonna feel right at home with this, I'm sure. So anyway, let's see, 133 tons, 2,200 hit points, just 100 over the Jag Tiger. 1,200 horsepower engine, top speed is 30 kilometers an hour, traverse is 20, gun traverse. Well, that doesn't make a difference, but that's 26. View range is 390. I'm at 391. That's just because I've got recon and I've got situational awareness. So that'll go up as my crew gets back up to 100%. When I switch a crew out to a new tank, I don't use gold to train them. I figure, you know, I'm 10, 15 games in, I'll be back up to where I'm at 100%. So. Signal range 720, so you're never going to lose touch with your light tanks, really. So anyway, let's get it out to battle. So I needed more gold because I spent most of it free XPing. I ground out about 100,000 free XP in the last 3 days. It's pretty quick when you've got a times 3, times 5. So I used up all my gold, so I decided, what the heck. I kind of missed some of the other rare tanks that, you know, I didn't buy the Fury at the time. What else is there? I don't know. There's a couple other tanks that I didn't end up buying, and I kind of regret it. Seeing the Fury now, I mean, it's not that good of a tank, you know, but you rarely see them. I'm gonna see if I can. No, he's down below them. What is our team doing, by the way? I have not a clue what our heavies are doing. So, if this doesn't work out very well, I'm probably gonna maybe play two more instead of just my normal total of two, because these guys are buffoons. Anyway, so I needed more gold. Back to my story. I needed more gold. I was down to about 900. The only thing I use with my gold is, or do with my gold, is buy premium time. So I figured, well, what the heck, I missed out on some of the other rare tanks. The Hydrostat is real rare. You used to have to, I think it was some special gift tank, and then I guess you could buy like a World of Tanks mouse made by Razer, which is what my mouse is, but anyway, you could buy this mouse and it came with a code for the Hydrostat. So I highly doubt, although I bet you on eBay somebody's probably sold one, or, you know, it's probably 150, 200 bucks or something stupid like that though. So needless to say, I decided that I was gonna snatch this one up this time, and that's what I did. So I've got myself some gold, got myself some more credits, which I normally don't recommend doing. I don't buy credits. I grind them out. But, you know, it's packaged in with it, so. Am I the only schmuck that's gonna make it to the hill on this thing, or what? This is pretty. Yeah. That just dove. Which kinda sucks. Oh, what in the world was that? Oh, it hit my freaking... I guess I should probably tell these guys how much longer I've got to... I don't know where that went. Almost feel like I'm playing artillery here. For little HE fired at me there by something. I don't know what that was. Oh, nice shot. Oh, jeez. Can I get any unluckier? I mean, I've shot, what, 3 or 4 rounds now and haven't hit a flipping thing? Oh, you've got to be freaking kidding me. This is ridiculous. You got a shell that's, you know, the size of my leg. And I'm not a fat guy or anything like that, but I've got some, you know, from lifting weights and stuff like that, I've got fairly good sized legs. This thing should be blasting through things, not being hitting the tracks. And he's, of course. Come on, bonehead. I'm gonna have to go up and get him out of there, I guess. See, at this angle, my lower plate is more of an angle because he's up above me. So he's gonna have an awfully hard time trying to pin me. He's firing heat at me now. Well, for the first game, this is a bit disappointing, to be honest with you. Come here, Mr. Batchat. I want to talk to you. He's probably going to dirt me here. Oh, is he going to go to his death? No, he tracked himself, though. Ah, balls, man. This battle's probably going to cost me $100,000 for all... Yeah, that's probably not that much. I don't know. Probably 30 grand in a repair bill and 15,000 in shots, and I haven't freaking hit a thing. And it's unbearably slow with a track out. Well, at least I know. Well, that's why this is a preview, I guess. At least I know that, it takes a pretty hefty gun firing heat to even really get through my front end. So, well, would you look at that? I only lost 4,200 credits with all of that. Zero damage. I must have got a lot of spotting in here or something. Yeah. Almost 2,500 in assistance damage, 2,400 blocked. Oh, I only shot 5 times. I hit twice. 0 penetrations. If I would have at least pinned that stinking IS-7, I could have gotten the kill on him. I know that. Because he was down to 500, 600, or, well, 800 health the first time I tracked him. Anyway, times 5, 4,615. So let's roll it out again and see what we can get done. All right, Red Shire from the north. I don't know. I would typically go on the hill with the TD, but they're outnumbering our heavies. So I think I'm gonna head that way. So, hopefully this is the right idea. I'm not sure yet. I don't know what this... I don't think... Does he honestly think he's pushing me? Oh. Got spotted already. That's not good. Oh, 1390 is down. I need to get behind a rock. Luckily, he wasn't an M50. If he would have seen us two running right behind each other, that's the shot I would have been taking. Maybe he didn't see the Waffenschrauger. So good to, I mean, I like the E100, you know, it's got a pretty good alpha, but this is just brutal. Marty's trying to hit the E100 there. Which is good for me. Come on out, bud. There you go. 1,057. That's what I like to hear. See, hear, and see. We're up to 2,184. I think they're both, all of these guys are probably, I mean, I get a little nervous when I see the Jagdpanzer E100 myself. So I know how these guys are feeling. I don't try to get hit by them very often. In fact, I try not to get hit by them the best I can, but... Ah, that bounced. Come on, Tiger 2, take a hit for me. Knucklehead. Oh yes, 1,054. I'm getting awfully sick and tired of this. T10 though. Yeah. Sucks, don't it? Good night. So now we need to get up on this. At least we won the east here. I think coming this way for me was the correct choice. So I need to throw my binoculars on this sucker. Almost reloaded. This was the game I was hoping for the whole time, you know. Maybe one or two of these games would have been nice. This T-34 is going to regret sitting in the cap. Oh, 12 damage. Really? Is it worth it?
Oh, man.
Apparently not. Come on, TVP. Spot at T-54. Ooh. You stay right where you're at, buddy. Probably not going to pin him, but... Oh, I did. And set him on fire. 4,698 damage. 440 blocked so far. Come on, Mr. Prototype. Ah. That's all right. And there's the T-110 E5 still hanging out in the cap. Oh, man. That could have been 1,042 damage, I'm sure. T-110 E4 hanging out up there. Which one should I shoot at? I'm thinking the E5. Ah. Bounced off his upper plate, it looks like. Lucky him. Come on, fellas. Oh, spot. Need a spot. Nice. Up to 5,740. I don't know why the siren is still going off, but something's weird there, huh? Little bug. Oh, and I got a TD mission. Oh, second class already. Three games in, well, not too bad, I guess. Got the Top Gun. Or, sorry, high caliber, not Top Gun. What am I talking about? Anyway, 5,740 damage, 2 kills, 829 base experience. Surprised we didn't get... I wonder... Sniper medal, I don't remember. 2,106 damage for more than 300 meters is pretty good. We fired 10 times. Hit 8, pinned 6, so not too bad. Blocked 440, a little bit of assistance damage. Ended up making 27,000 credits, which is pretty good. I'm happy with that. Anytime you can make credits in a tier 10, it's a good match. And 1,244 experience with the premium account. So, I got some credits there too. Another 300,000. That's the other thing. I've got a couple other tanks. I've got to do the Hydrostat. Preview, I guess. I don't know if I'm going to do a preview of that or not. But I ended up unlocking the T-28 finally. After, forever. I thought it was a dream at first. You know, I'd seen these things on the battlefield. And just never could get my hands on one until I finally passed the mission that I've been trying for. I've got a replay of that I'll show you too. So, got some pretty cool stuff coming up here pretty soon. Anyway, the review of the Jagdpanzer, or the preview of the Jagdpanzer. Obviously, huge gun. You saw the damage output. It's notorious for the damage output. This and the 183. So, and the armor held up pretty well. That last battle I didn't, I probably could have played it a little differently, angled a little more here and there, but, I find that, I don't know, maybe I'm just trying to bully my way through with the gun. I'll probably change my playstyle the more I play it, I'm sure, but, armor's good. The, The gun is excellent, and if you want a TD, it's turretless, you know. So there's a stigma about that. I mean, you know, you can't. If you're like this, you're screwed. So that's the only downside to them. But excellent gun, excellent armor. So I give it a big thumbs up myself. If you're looking for a TD, I think this is probably just as good as the 183 as far as damage output. I don't know. I mean, obviously not as far as alpha goes, but overall, I think this tank can probably hold up just as well or better in a situation where you're getting fired on, as long as you can keep them in front of you, that is. So, anyway, I'm babbling on, but definitely a good pickup. I liked all of the tanks in this line. This whole going back, you know, I didn't get the Ferdinand. I went down the Jagdpanzer too. I like the mobility a little more. That's why I went down this line. You know, being that you're going from the Jagdpanzer, this is the natural progression. The Ferdinand is kind of the oddball, and that's probably why it's like this. But this whole line, I went from the Martyr to the Hetzer. I did unlock the 38T to go up this line, not to continue on this way. So the Hetzer is fun. You got the 105 derp gun. The Stug, same thing, fun. The Jagdpanzer 4, not so much. The Jagdpanzer is good. The Jagdpanzer 2 is excellent. The Jag Tiger progresses on, gets your heavier side going. You know, once you've played this for a while, you're gonna fit right in here, I think. I feel, you know, just a better gun is all it is. And a little better armor. But once you learn how to play the Jag Tiger, I think I'll do fine on the E100 here. So definitely go down this line. If you haven't done any TDs yet, this and the Russian, you know, the ISU line there, the 152, I should say, and the SU-152, that side of it is fun as well. But between the two of them, I like this better. So anyway, appreciate you guys hanging out, watching a little bit of fast previews. I'll maybe get 50, 75 battles in this thing and do a full review of it. Although, you know, you've pretty much seen it, but I'll probably be a little better in it by then, I'm hoping. So, anyway, we shall see you next time, and have a good one.